In this video, we will be discussing many-to-many relationships and how they can be used to allow your database to cope with more complex situations. There is a free download of the database we will be using in this video available on our website. See the description below for the link. This video follows on from our stock management database tutorial, so if you have not yet seen this video, click the annotation or the link in the description below to start there first. The problem. In the stock management database we created in our previous video, we used the example of a database managing supplies of parts. As you may remember from that video, we kept things simple by assuming each customer only ordered one part at a time. This is too simplistic for most businesses, as customers will often order many parts from a supplier on one order. In our previous video, we linked the parts and orders table directly through a one-to-many relationship. This relationship will allow each part in the parts table to be on many orders, but each order can only contain one part. If customers want to order several parts at once from you, this will not work. What is needed here is what's called a many-to-many relationship. How to solve it. You cannot create a direct many-to-many link in Access between the two tables, so to create this relationship, you will need an intermediate table between the two. In this case, we are going to call it Order Items. The Orders table contains a record for each time a customer places an order with you. The Order Items table lists the parts requested on each order. Each of your tables, orders, and parts link to this table with a one-to-many relationship. So each order can link to multiple order items, and each part can appear in multiple order items. This will allow you to receive orders of several different parts at a time from customers. The new table needs to have its own unique primary key, like all tables, and then a field that is the same as each primary key of the linking tables. Let's see this in practice. Create the table. As before, create a new table and create a unique ID field. As this is a joining table, there is no specific number or code to use as a primary key, so just create a separate auto number ID field for this, called Order Item ID. Next, create the fields that will link to the orders and parts tables. These should be the same names and field types as the primary keys in those tables, which are Order No and Part No respectively. One thing to remember is that there may be fields in the Orders table that should move into the new Order Items table because they are specific to each line on the order rather than to the order itself. For us, the Order Quantity field in the Orders table is an example of this, as the customer will specify the quantity of each part that they want. You will need to move this from the Orders table and add it to the Order Items table. Note that as each order will be from a single customer and on a single date, the other fields, customer ref and order date, should stay in the orders table. We don't have any other fields to move here, but you may in your database. Relationships. Once you've created your table, you can link up the tables. As in our previous video, use the lookup wizard to create these relationships. For the Order No relationship, we might want to see more than one field in the lookup to determine which order the items are linked to. So we'll add the customer and the date to this. Doing the same for the Part No, we have now created our relationships. Going to the relationship window, we can now enforce referential integrity as before, and add cascade updates. You may remember from the previous video we discussed cascade deletes. In this case, the relationship between orders and order items is one situation where we would usually enable this, since order items without an order are meaningless. And if you want to delete an order, then you will also want to delete all items on the order. Note that this is not the case for the relationship between parts and order items. Without this setting, you will not be able to delete a part that appears on an order item record. This is safer so that you don't lose order item details. And that's all there is to it. Now we can enter an order and enter several items for each order at a time. Note that in our download associated with this video, we have also added in another many-to-many relationship between parts and purchase orders. This will allow you to have several different parts on a particular purchase order. There are other locations within the database where a many-to-many relationship might be useful, for example between suppliers and parts. If you order a particular part from several different suppliers, due to cost or quantity, and each supplier supplies several different parts, this will require a supplier parts table between the two. Using the skills you have gained from this video, try adding this table yourself if this is something that might be useful for you. We hope you enjoyed this video. If you decide that creating your own stock control database isn't for you and would like some advice or assistance, call us on 01747 822 616 for a free consultation. Subscribe to our channel for more tips on using Microsoft Access or visit our website at www.software-matters.co.uk. Thanks for watching.